So we've built an OpenAI integration into PubNub functions. You need to be able to make API calls to access the AI model. And part of the challenge is how do you secure your API key, especially when you go to production and you want your users to be able to take advantage of large language models. The only way to do it is to have a secure code execution environment, and you have to host your API key in a secrets manager. And this is something that PubNub provides to our customers at ease. It's really easy to get that integrated. We made it even easier by putting a button on our website that you can click, and it immediately instantiates the code, and you can click deploy, and it deploys proactively across all of our regions. Now, this is a little different. You compare it to other providers who they host your code, right? But where we're different is that we distribute that globally. And we make that so easy that it's automatic. That's just the default. That's how it works immediately, because your users are all over the place. And we call that proactive replication. There's some other vendors that have similar models, but they're reactive replication in some cases, which means it's slow for some users on some of the requests. And it's indeterminate which requests are slow, but we decided that we're a real-time company and we want to make sure that every single time it's fast for the end users. One of the challenges today, especially with generative AI, is it's a lot easier to write code now. There's this giant paintbrush that makes it super easy. So even if you're a junior engineer, now you can program like a senior engineer. So it's changing the world. And a lot of that just sort of baseline code, that bootstrapping code bit, we just wanted to take that and make sure that it was really, really easy with a button click. So at any level of engineer experience, you will be able to secure your code and get large language models in production without any challenge. So that's one of the big bits. And from a big business, you said enterprise perspective, very large companies with a lot of engineers, PubNub has added that level of compliance and security that are required for those businesses, especially some of the regionality laws, locality, data sovereignty, and compliance. We have that out of the gate to make sure that is available to our users. Yeah, so one of the use cases I've used in the past, and I'm actually gonna use next week with an engineer so we can get more content. While we're on a Zoom call, I can click record and enable transcripts. And so what that does is I'll ask questions, I'll get answers, then I ask more questions, just in an interview for like 5 minutes. And then I can take the AI and have it automatically run through a series of steps. And it'll transform that interview transcript into an article. And then I can transcript that article into something that's more in the tone of our business needs, right? We can speak to our audience in the right way. And then I can go in and edit it and make sure all the things look good. And that part of the process, that initial bit, just turning the transcript into an article, that can be done automatically now. And that's one of the use cases that we're providing. And just with the base AI models, you're missing out at some of the more modern information, the more recent information. And so what we've done is we're integrating the ability to pull in information that might be in your private repositories, your documents, your Google Docs, or your wiki pages, and then allowing that to be ported in. So that way that part of the knowledge can inject itself into the conversation. Here's another fun one. So the idea is once you've already done that interview, you can start pulling out interesting, like short bite-sized contents that can be used as the filler, as the title, the content information. So you even can focus on keywords that you're targeting and say, here's the article. I need some tweets, right? Some bite-sized quick bits. And they also need these keywords. And that can be part of that workflow. So not only now do I have an article that's ready to go, but I also have some tweets and some posts ready to go. Computer can do it for you. We have a dedicated AI team at PubNub that is 100% focused on this. as well as our other product teams are actively integrating various solution spaces of AI into our products. So what we're going to see is more and more pre-built and ready to use cases that streamline the day-to-day. And I mentioned some use cases for marketing, but this goes into every single department. Yeah, so there are some tedious tasks in software engineering, such as writing code comments that are conforming to the standards and writing unit tests that are clean and able to be, you know, actually useful. We've found patterns and we've implemented those patterns that allow us to not have to do that anymore. We just write what we need to, write the primary code, and then the generative models, they can do those tedious tasks for us. I want to change some of the behaviors that we have here at PubNub, some of our, like, just our stance and like our thought about what code is, and sort of treat it more like it's throwaway, because we can regenerate it, right? Once we start getting better and better at using AI tools and these techniques, we can just create initial patterns that we're comfortable with and that we know have good architecture patterns, and then click regenerate. And so we don't even have to worry about that. Like, it's just this new software paradigm that we're going to start seeing in the industry take hold. We have a long arc of AI coming in the rest of this year. We have all of our engineering teams have some form of AI being baked into it. That's just because it's going to be expected. This is going to be an expected part of features that are released with every product. And if you don't have it, there'll be people asking, why? Why don't you have this? I mean, they do over there. What's missing? Yeah. So it's a table stakes. It's a requirement. And we're not going to miss that opportunity. There is some interesting approaches with where large language models and generative AI is coming to play. Today, it requires a lot of compute. It's very expensive and they're slow. However, as we're seeing a lot of the use cases getting solved with those models, even though they're slow, you can actually port a lot of those use cases over to tailored AI models that are much more accurate and much more fast at doing their job. And we're going to see that shift and that pivot. We're identifying, for example, some of those marketing opportunities, right? With sort of automating our day-to-day with marketing efforts. We can do that with tailored, specific built models that can do it in seconds rather than tens of seconds. All that innovation is still locked away, right? It's still hard to access because a lot of us have, you know, our day-to-day, we do pull up ChatGPT. We open that up, we have it do stuff for us. We might try some of the other models that have chat interfaces, but the innovation isn't there. It's actually with data models that aren't hosted yet, that are easy access. It require a lot of heavy lifting. And those kinds of models, once they're production ready, we will provide those to our customers and make their lives that much easier. So there is a generative AI model that doesn't exist yet. No one has built it. You know, we came out with images and those were kind of neat and a little scary, but now they're getting really good. And we came out with some video and we see voice and audio. We can recreate speech after coming to text, but something that we have yet to create is speech to speech. Wouldn't it be great? Wouldn't it be neat if you and I could speak back and forth where an AI would understand your voice, your tone, and all those other aspects, and then be able to respond back. That kind of model does not exist. That is not available today. And I would be very satisfied to see. You could talk in real time to even anyone you wanted to, any celebrity, and it would be them, it'd be like, it'd sound exactly like them, and they would have emotion. I wanna try it so bad. I think it would be really fun. That one's gonna be the next very interesting model that we see in the industry. So if you're a developer and you're integrating OpenAI into your project, one of the things that's really easy and fun is when you're running it locally on your laptop, which is your own secure code execution environment, right? You can pop it up an IDE, and then click the run button, and it works. It's perfect. But when you need to deploy that application, here's the problem. You don't want to give that API key to your end users. So what do you do? You have to create a hosted secure code execution environment. And that tends to come with a lot of options. There's so many options out there, and it's challenging to pick which one. Wouldn't it be easy if there was just a button? And guess what? We built that button for you. We made it super easy. And so now you can host your code globally distributed to all of AWS regions, making it really easy for you to have a secure code execution environment that hosts your API.